Good day children, Sai Ram, and welcome back to our fourth session of chapter number 5, Social and Religious Reforms. Children, in our previous lectures, we have learnt about the era of religious and social reforms in which we have learnt about the various institutions started by our reformers like the Brahmo Samaj, the Prarthana Samaj, the Satyashodhak Samaj, the Arya Samaj. These were the various institutions started by our reformers. Then we have also learned about the emancipation of women. And this emancipation of women was possible just because of the people like Pandit Ishwar Chandra Vidyasagar, then Vishnu Shastri Pandit, then Veeresh Lingam, Gopal Ganesh Agarkar, Mahatma Jyotirao Phule, Savitri Bai Phule, then Pandita Ramabai, then Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar, Mahatma Gandhi. These were all the people who struggled very hard for the emancipation of women. And just because of this contribution only, the women had come out now, had brought about an awakening. Okay, and they also participated in the freedom movement. So here we are going to learn more about them. Women had given valuable contribution during the freedom movement. Okay, it was just because of their participation only that the unjust practices in our society was abolished. Which were the unjust practices I am talking about? That is parda system, okay, then child marriage, sati system, then what else, dowry system. These were the unjust practices in our society which were abolished just because of the contribution of the women only. Okay, unless and until the women participated in the abolishment of these practices, it would have not been possible. So the voice of the women had broken out now. How it had broken out? Just because of the awakening that had been brought among them. Okay, their contribution was very much valuable. Now women started putting up their thoughts also through their writings in newspapers, magazines. Okay, their thoughts would be expressed in that. The performance in every sectors of life flourished due to education. Okay, this had become possible just because of education. That in every sector of life, their performance was clear now. Okay, so this is how the women had contributed to the freedom movement. Now let's learn about the religious reforms among the Muslims. Okay, now as the women had come up now, they had brought about an awakening among the women. Now slowly the reformers started turning their attention towards their religion. Okay, for example, firstly we'll talk about is the Muslim Abdul Latif. What he did? He started the social reform movement in the Muslim community. For that, he established the Mohammedan Literarian Society in Bengal. Okay, he established the Mohammedan Literarian Society in Bengal. Even people like Sir Sayyid Ahmad Khan, they also contributed in this. So Sir Sayyid Ahmad Khan, what he did? He founded the Mohammedan Anglo-Oriental College. Later on, this Anglo-Oriental College was renamed as Aligarh Muslim University. Okay, previously it was known as Mohammedan Anglo-Oriental College. Why had he started this college? He believed that only science and technology can bring about an awakening among the Muslim community. Okay, it was possible to bring about an awakening, to bring about a changes in the Muslim community through science and technology. So he advocated Western science and technology. He believed that Muslims could make progress only by studying modern education and science. Only he had started this college, that is the Anglo-Mohammedan Anglo-Oriental College. Here is a picture of Sir Syed Ahmed Khan. Nextly, we'll talk about the Hindu society. Now, let's see how the Hindu society had brought about an awakening. Okay, how the Hindu society was changing and who brought about an awakening in the Hindu society. In the year 1915, Hindu Mahasabha was established. Why this Hindu Mahasabha was established? To give a respectable position to the Hindu community. That was the main aim of this Hindu Mahasabha. Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya, what he did? He laid the foundation of Banaras Hindu University. Then people like Dr. Keshav Baliram Hedgewar, he also in the year 1925 established Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangha in Nagpur. Okay, he had established this Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangha in Nagpur in the year 1925. What was the aim behind this? To bring about a disciplinary and virtuous organization of Hindu youth. That was the main aim of this Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangha at Nagpur. Even V.D. Savarkar, Vinayak Damodar Savarkar, he built the Patita Pavan Temple, which was open to all castes of Hindu religion. Because he wanted to bring all the Hindus together and to bring about an awakening among the Hindus, to abolish all the superstition belief what was there in the Hindu society. For all this reason, he wanted to bring the Hindu people together. He also started the common dining programs, wherein people could come together, talk to each other, know each other. That was the main aim behind that. Okay, so what was the contribution? Who all contributed to the Hindu society? First of all, it was Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya. Then Dr. Keshav Baliram Hedgewar, who started the Rashtriya Swayamsevak Sangha. Then V.D. Savarkar, who started the Patita Pavan Temple. And also a common dining program was established so that the Hindu people will come together and contribute to the freedom movement. Here is the photograph of Dr. Keshav Baliram Hedgewar. Here is small Do You Know part is there. Let's see what is there in this Do You Know part. Manifestation of Renaissance in other areas. Just as there was reform movement, the development in various fields of literature, art and science during the Renaissance period is also important. In the field of literature, Rabindranath Tagore, and in the field of science, C.V. Raman, they received the Nobel Prize. This gives an idea that the Indian society was on the verge of progressing. This progress was responsible for building up modern India. Stories, novels gave inspiration to gain independence. Okay? Various stories in the newspapers or in the magazines, okay, the novels. What had happened? This had brought about a great awakening among the Indian people. And this was like an inspiration to gain independence. They also expressed thoughts on social reforms. During this period, women also took up writing. New newspapers and magazines became a source of social reform and political awakening. There was development in the field of art as well. Music became more popular. Indian style and Western techniques were combined and a new school of painting came forward. Many books were written based on science. People started realizing that experimentation and scientific attitude were important for the progress of the country. Understood, children? So as the people needed to be awakened, so also what changes were brought about in the field of art, science, literature, that also is mentioned in this Do You Know part. Okay, children, I hope till here you all have understood. Let's move forward. Yes, children, what have we learned till now over here? We have learned about the women's contribution in the various fields. Okay, then we have learned about the reforms among the Muslims. Okay, the various people who brought about these reforms in among the Muslims, that is Abdul Latif. Then we have learned about Sir Syed Ahmad Khan, what was their contribution in the modernization of a Muslim community, that we have learned. Then we have learned about the awakening that brought about awakening of the Hindu society, in which whose contribution was there. First of all, because of the establishment of the Hindu Mahasabha, then the contribution of Pandit Madan Mohan Malviya, who started the Banaras Hindu Society, Hindu University. Then we have learned about Dr. Keshav Baliram Hedgewar, okay, who had started the Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangha. Then we have learned about the contribution of V.D. Savarkar, who had started the built the Patit Pavan Temple at Ratnagiri. Okay, this was the contribution for the Hindu society. Then we have learned about the Do You Know part, the various fields in which the Renaissance had taken place. So here we are going to learn, we are going to end up the lesson in fact. Here in the history of modern India, when we talk about modern India, when we talk about the history of modern India, the movement of Renaissance plays a very, very important role. Okay, the movement of Renaissance here means the changes that were brought about in the society, in the various people. Okay, just because of the various organizations like the Brahmo Samaj, Satyashodhak Samaj, Arya Samaj. Okay, then the awakening that are brought about among the women, that is the emancipation of women. Then the awakening that was brought about in the Hindu and the Muslim community. Okay, all this plays a very important role when we talk about the history of modern India. So, on the principles of liberty, equality and nationalism, the Indian social reformers set up a nationwide political movement. Okay, on the principles of liberty, equality, what is liberty? Freedom. Equality means equalness, and nationalism. Your nationalism means nation. It is my nation. It is our nation, and we have to struggle for its freedom. Okay, so these were the principles on which the Indian social reformers had started working upon. They had started taking into consideration these principles. They had started a nationwide awakening. Okay, and to bring about a nationwide political movement in India. This was the main aim of this social reformers. Okay, so here we are in the next lesson, we are going to learn more in detail about this liberty, equality and nationalism. Understood, children? I hope you all have understood this lesson very well. That's all about this lesson, children. We'll meet with the next new lesson in the next lecture. Till then, thank you, children.